say?
And then,
eh?
What
say?
Nyamaza, madam.
Oh my God, what did I do to deserve all this?
Bro, ile mpango yangu iko karibu kuivana. Oh baby, tunafaa tumtoe kafara. Ha? Wait, unataka kumtoa kafara Masai?
Nani anataka kafara?
Sasa, acha nikwambie.
Babe, like serious.
Acha nikwambie.
Wewe goja, unataka kutoa kafara?
It's me.
Goja nikwambie, tulia bro.
Babe.
Sasa, wewe acha nikwambie.
Let us know what is
Where?
This man?
Why?
Hey, come on.
Unataka kumtoa kafara kwa nini?
Unanijua mimi?
No, you can't. You can't do this.
Ebu simama.
You can't.
Ebu simama na huko.
Utakunipushi.
Nini ina happen bro? Yaani unajua mimi? Sisi lazima tuoe mabibi wengi.
Na kafara inakujia wapi
kwa hizi? No, no way, no way.
Huyu alinikatalia mimi. So najaribu kutumia njia nyingine ndio niwe mabibi wawili nitimize mila yetu.
So kwa mila ulikuwa
umeambia. Like serious, like serious, like serious. Wewe, what is this? Nini unaniplania? Unaniplania nini?
Unanijua mimi?
Nini unaniplania? Unaniplania nini? Unaniplania nini? Unaniplania nini? Eh, nini unaniplania? Unanifukuza mbona? Why? 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 Why?
Masai, mbona unataka kumtoa kafara kwa jamani? Simama Masai, unajua hii inaweza ingia kwa serikali bana. Simama.
Yaani unataka kunitoa kafara mimi?
Mbona unataka kumtoa kafara bana?
Nini na happen?
Simama Masai, simama bana. Simama ni juu hata niko na simu yake.
Kunifanya hivi.
Eh, Masai bana. Usijaribu kufanya kitu kama hiyo.
Like serious.
Unataka kumtoa kafara bro?
Oh my God.
Tarani timiza ajibu ame.
Okay, hebu simama, niambie kwani ulikuwa umetimiza?
Mwambie nisisogele. Mwambie akae mbali na mimi.
Okay, kwani ulikuwa mbona unataka kumtoa kafara bro?
Huyu alinikatalia. Nilimwambia lazima niwe mabibi wengi, ananikatalia.
So daktari umesema ni hapa?
Yeah, ni hapa. Mgonjwa yuko hivyo.
Oh, I
believe the nurse is attending to him. Yeah.
Okay, show me. Yeah. Show me. Tuone ni.
Come and see.
Thank you.
Yes.
Ah,
oh, wow. Here is our patient.
Okay.
Yes,
hi.
Doctor, hi.
Are you? Uh-huh. Are you doctor?
I'm here with Yuzi. Yuzi is the guy who brought this unconscious man. But right now you're conscious, right?
Yeah.
I can see even the eyes are good. Okay. Yeah. That's so good. So Yuzi, here is the guy.
Are you?
I'm fine.
Chalikai katikati jio mic.
Okay.
Najua watu watashangaa mic haifiki.
It's okay.
So, by the way guys, let me first tell them why we didn't record. Najua hatujawaambia kwa nini hatujarecord tukikuja all the way to here. It's because of other patients. Na ukaniambia, you told me?
There are other patients and due to, we don't want to bring commotion.
Okay.
Yeah, so that's why we are just recording it here.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's amazing. Thank you so much. So, how are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Naitwa Yuzi. Minon leta, huu ni kuita vipi?
Naitwa Nastaimi.
Kaimi.
Yeah.
Oh, nice to meet you. How is him?
He's quite okay. He's quite okay. He's far much better. Okay. Kuliko venye alikuja ile siku mlimleta. Umenipata katika harakati ya kuchukua
pole.
Majina zake. We do not know him. Apparently when an unconscious and unresponsive patient comes to the hospital, we give them the name Majondo. Ama hii hospitali imekuja na forum. Tunaanza yule nurse atakuingisha kwa hospitali, we give letters according to alphabets too. So for our friend here alipata letter F, tukamuita Philip. But Philip is just but a character name. You were in the process of meeting me, taking now his full details.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. You can continue as the doctor explains to me what is happening here. How are you, doctor?
Oh, yeah. It is very important for history taking. Once we have the patient conscious, it is very important to take the history. We know actually what happened. we know what actually happened, so that as we treat, you know, we can just, we cannot just bump in and say that this patient is this and this way. We must take history, we must go through some tests so that we determine fully what's happening. But then, as you can see, the patient isn't even talking. So meaning good work has been done on Philip, the name that the hospital gave him. Yeah. But as the nurse will collect the data, we shall be able to know actually who is he, whether he has someone to take care, and also it will be very important as we also discharge him, we know whether where he is going, is it safe, so that if it is not safe, we can also involve the security, because that is their job also, to ensure people are safe. So we can involve them to ensure that Philip is safe. Oh. Yeah, yeah.
Let me hear something from the nurse. Huh? Okay. If I may ask, nurse Kaimi, your name is forgetting. If I may ask, according to what the Philip have been going, vile imekuwa mkimtunza, kuna kitu umeona imechange within that time?
Well, I can say that I have seen. Me and my team, we have seen a very big improvement. First, akikuja, alikuwa unconscious, but now everything in his system is working just but fine. Uptake yake, heart rate yake imeimprove, BP yake imeimprove. I'm sure the doctor explained what is a worse BP and a normal BP. His BP right now is as normal as yours can be. We have also seen an improvement in his motor functioning. He can move his hands, as you can see amejisupport na mikono, miguu zake akiwiggle toes zitafanya kazi, so he's quite okay. He's basically okay. Ni compare to D5, another
D5 ndio nini, unajua ni vizuri mnipeleke na mtaratara. D5 ni nini?
D5 is a diet, is a liquid diet given to malnourished patients. Okay. For his case, he was, our patient was malnourished, so we introduced D5 into his system. D5 is basically food but liquid form. This enables, we give it in liquid form because when something is in liquid, there is a high rate of metabolism and uptake by the body compared to solid food.
Umelipoteza.
Haya, kwa lugha raisi, ukikula chakula, tuseme mahindi, when it is solid, maize, it takes a long time for it to be digested and absorbed. But with the solution D5, it is in liquid form and it has high glucose levels. So when it is in liquid form, it is uptaken by the body haraka sana. The cells get to take in the food haraka sana kama juu iko flowy. Ni maji, okay. As compared to chakula ngumu, solid food.
Na ni vizuri tu unanielezea vizuri ndio nielewe, because I'm sure wewe unaelewa zaidi kuniliko.
No, I understand. Okay, continue. So we give him D5, he's improving. We have seen tremendous improvement. Ako sawa sawa, hana shida. Say atalala huku, he will spend another night and we will write discharge papers tomorrow.
Okay. So kesho anaweza kuwa ready to be discharged.
Kesho anaweza kuwa ready to be discharged. Oh. We have to just keep him overnight na tumweke to be closely observe and monitor his improvements. And when he's okay, he will be ready by tomorrow in the morning. Say 9 a.m. atakuwa natoka hospitali.
Yeah. Sasa niulize bro, unafeel aje?
Sahi niko at least, hadi naweza ongea, sikia niko na nguvu. Jumi niliamka tu asubuhi na shindo niko wapi. Yeah, I thank God for that.
Okay, do you know me?
So you on YouTube. Yeah, I guess it was around morning time.
Oh, morning, eh? Yeah. That is when they showed you where you came from, eh?
Yeah.
Me to Uzi, okay. And we found you. Itaveri, ulikuwa umefungwa. Sio kama mlimuonyesha hizo video vizuri ama mliogopa kumuonyesha.
You know, as you receive a patient, it is not so good to bombard him with all everything at the same time.
Sure.
Yeah. Uh-huh. But then I believe you will get to see. Anyway, don't worry. You are at a better condition right now. Uh-huh. Yeah.
So, mimi ndo nilikuleta hapa hospitali. Ulikuwa hali mbaya sana. Hali tali tatanishi. And what is your name?
I'm Joseph Mwangi.
Oh, you're Joseph Mwangi.
Yeah.
Just like me. Yeah, Joseph Mwangi.
Yeah, yeah, Joseph Mwangi.
Unafilaje?
Yeah, mi nashukuru Mungu kwanza and may God bless you for your kindness. Yeah. At least now I was in a bad condition, but I thank God now I can walk, I can talk, I can smile, I can see, can smile.
Yeah, that's why you're feeling good.
Yeah, I'm feeling good. Yeah.
Daktari hapa amekutunza vizuri. Unajua we looked you mali tulikuacha huko the other side. But sasa tumesikia tena ukapelekwa paka kwa nutrition. Ukafanywa nini? I hope una feel vizuri.
Yeah. Na feel vizuri kabisa. Because the last thing I can remember, I was starving. But now my stomach is full. Yeah, my mind has relaxed. Yeah, I'm okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
So what would you advise him to take, maybe akikuwa discharged, like afanywe nini?
Akikuwa discharged, I will advise that for the wounds that he had and the ties he's from the
roadside.
Ninge advise aziendelee kuzinas and aza kuja aza check in the hospital, kwa outpatient department at adresiwa vizuri from time to time. As I was saying, I will advise him to come for dressing,
sure.
Maybe from 2 to 3 days, I come dressing for the outpatient department at adresiwa vizuri, and he will take home some painkillers for the pain. Because of the ties, the joints have some amount of
red pain.
Na kutoa yo red, ninge recommend. Aende na painkillers, which the doctors had andikad. Yes.
Alikuwa ameziandika zote. Ni lugha ya kawaida. Bora tunaelewana ama vipi daktari?
Yeah, it's okay. I think what the nurse said will work out for him. And for also quick recovery on the woods. I don't know if you'll buy him fruits kwa wengi.
Yeah, fruits hata tumekuja nazo ziko pale kwa gari.
Oh yeah.
Bila sasa tungeingia nazo kwanza kama hatujamaliza what you have told me. Yeah. Na pia unajua the process of from there to nini? Yeah. Commotion
nini? Actually, they are not allowed in so easily. But then after we discharge him, you'll just find some fruits, get to him to help repair the tissues as mommy. And then also, I hope Pia Kitoka, he'll not come back because of the same situation,
sure,
of not eating. So maybe we can just be sure that the patient is food secure. He's able to acquire what to eat, what to drink. And yeah, it will be okay.
It will be very best. Eh?
Yeah, yeah.
So Sai is in a position to maybe eat hard food, it's only fruits.
Right now, as the nurse has said, he's on D5.
D5,
yeah.
Okay, so hiyo D5 iko na kila kitu.
Yeah, it has everything.
Okay. Umesema ito Joseph Mwangi.
Yeah, my name is Joseph Mwangi. Yeah.
Just taki tuongee mingi sana because the story between you is very, very, very big. Eh? But if I may ask the doctor or the nurse, is something I want you to tell me.
Mm-hmm.
Kama saimu nisema atapata that D5.
Mm-hmm.
And the nurse told me some painkillers maybe to ease the pain. Vile yako anaka red huko. Unajua hata watu wabujui bona ako na sweater. They are not understanding everything. It's because guys, our community guidelines as they allow mutu akuwa na braces like akuwa uchi. That is why by the ulikuwa umesikia nimesema at least avae kuifiti because of hizo unajua hizo mavidonda zinakaa vibaya. And even people who are watching, it is maybe some are sensitive. Sini kweli? That is why tumemvalisha. And nimesema to avarishwe, at least ni wakuwa in a position. Because hizo cuts nini. Kuna mtutu pale maze ya na watch, akona roho soft maze, anasikia vibaya. Wenipata, na tutaki tuwalete pain. Whereas we are happy that the guy is talking, is in a comfortable state, sahihi anaendelea vizuri. And okay, so as I was asking, umesema that the nurse told me that anafaa ku take some painkillers. And now ukasema pia take hiyo D5. What about how long will it take for him to start eating normally, maybe hard food?
Right now he's able to start eating, but because of the nutrient requirement in his body, he might not get all the nutrients from these divided food. So that's why we are only giving the five, because it has all the nutrients required at a good amount, or the required amount. That's why it's good for him right now. So at least by Kesho, I know he can take any other thing. But even the food is okay, right? The liquid.
Inaonekana kijana wamekutesa vibaya sana.
Ni Mungu niko hapa.
But I love this is like a family. These are the family I brought you to. At least wakutunze. I see you have good nurses here and daktari, but utarecover na utafeel vizuri. Have you taken the other records zenye ulikuwa unachukua?
Yes, I have.
Sorry, could distract ukasahau.
Yeah, mlipata nikiwa katikati, so I've taken the remaining part of the history, mm-hmm. and we are good. What I would maybe add to what the doctor said is, akirudi nyumbani hafai kwenda peke yake, because as you know, his body is still weak, but not as weak as he came in. So he needs to start with slow food. So we need to start him on easy food, easy digestible food, rice, maybe porridge, a lot of fruits, a lot of water. This will help in preparing his digestive system for much harder complex food. So he will munyata guardian munyata enda na yeye. They will have to make sure that the diet the patient gets to take is a diet that is so easy for the digestive system to take up to easily. Then he can gradually move to hard food, yes.
Okay.
Lakini hawezi mtoa hospitali and then when do wanze kumpea githiri na ugali.
Wanze kupatia mukimo.
Hey, tamaliza bana. Start easy, rice, porridge. Ni kama mtoto tu.
Sure.
Just weaning off the effect of the malnutrition, you start with easy food. And then we can proceed gradually to the hard food.
I think, you said it all. The patient, are you, do you know him now?
Yeah.
So go comfortable na
ye? Yeah, niko comfortable.
So Kesho, akikuja kuchukua, there is no problem.
Okay.
You'll be okay.
I'll be okay.
Because he's the one who brought you. Yeah. And we don't want to have a situation whereby tumekupea tena kwa mtu mwingine mwenye. Yeah, so if you're comfortable, tomorrow the nurse will release you, will discharge you, and you'll be now on dia tumezoea. Ukianza kidogo kidogo, dia amekueleza, si ndio? Yeah, so Yuzi, that's good. Thank you for helping a brother.
Sure.
It was good, wasababu. That being so much malnourished can lead to death.
Sure.
And it's good you have saved a life. Mm-hmm. Brother, it's good. Now, are you sure of where you're going from after here? Do you know where you're going?
No, I'm not sure.
What do you mean, Nanda? We'll talk at this.
Kama mmekuja na huyo. Unasema kuletwa hapa ama unasema
like unakaa wapi?
Nakaa Dhika.
Dhika. Uko na nyumba?
Yeah, niko na nyumba.
Na mtu mwingine mwenye uko naye kwa nyumba?
Hapana.
Hauna mtu?
Yeah, niko peke yangu.
Na umekuwa ukisurvive aje? Unafanya kazi gani?
Small hustle. Artist, I'm an artist.
You're an artist.
Drawing. Yeah, I do art.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So wapi Dhika specific? Unajua pia daktari lazima ni vizuri ajue, because maybe anaweza
hitajika. Yeah, Makongeni.
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 Oh.
And yeah. Your neighbors know you are here?
I don't know that. I'm not sure.
Okay.
Kuna simu?
Yeah.
Hana kitu huyu tulimpata mfuko tupu.
Oh.
Kama alikuwa nayo labda aliibiwa.
Na namba ya mtu mwenye unajua ya familia?
Tunaweza mpigia.
Naweza jaribu kukumbuka.
Yeah, baba.
Yeah, I have it. Yeah. You pay nurse. Yeah.
I niko na namba ya mgonjwa, niko na namba ya mamake na babake. So we will just contact them wakuja mchukue.
Mm-hmm.
Then they can assist him in the recovery.
Okay.
Yeah. That's very important. You know, it's important to know at least the next of kin so that we are very sure of his safety.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, thank you.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's all. But then, bada tabaki hapa leo. So tomorrow is where you'll come to pick him.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, no problem. Just say. Jali utasikia vizuri. Kesho pia tutakuja in case the nurse umesema atapiga simu tujue kama kuna mtu atakuja, but in case hatutawapata we'll take you there. But pia tutachukua kama itakuwa possible tuende na one of your nurses, tutamrudisha sisi wenyewe ndio for safety, ndio ajue pia mahali mgonjwa anaenda ama itakuwa vipi.
That one might not really be possible because of the workload. In fact, we have also taken a lot of time here. I believe we have a lot of workload to deal with other patients. So I will just, since we have the history that it is safe and the patient is comfortable with you, so it's just okay. Because so we cannot have a nurse leaving. Because if you have a nurse leaving, we have a pending work. And patients are here. They need someone to attend to them. So I think you'll just go with him tomorrow.
Thank you so much, Dr. Humphrey. Mazemi nimefurahia. Nas Kaemi. Kaemi. Thank you so much for taking for taking care of the patient. Kama si nyenye mazee, mimi najua singe mtibu.
It's our job.
It's your job.
It's our job.
Na kama si nyenye.
Yeah.
Thank you so much. I don't know what to thank you with. I don't know what to gift you with, but you saved a life. The guy, me, I don't know him literally. I don't know him, to be honest. Nimemjua, but now he's okay. He's favoring well. He's faring well, but aki asanteni. Sasa,
good.
I appreciate. Right. And pia kwa kazi yenye mkwe fiti. Sini kweli?
That's good.
Thank you so much, the nurse. Asanteni. Wacha nione kama mgonjwa atanipatia detail moja, mbili, but then tujue vile tuta. Kama sisi tutoke, tuwapate hapo, tujue kama ni kachai tutakunywa, tujue vile itakuwa siri kweli.
It's okay. So, I think the patient can, can he access the patient?
He's free, so as long as, yes. He's free, he's good.
Okay.
So you can just talk with him a few minutes.
Okay.
Yeah. Because of also the restrictions, okay. I believe you just a few minutes, okay. Then we finish.
Okay, thank you. Okay.
1 minute, 1 minute and a half.
It will be enough, eh?
Yeah.
No problem. Thank good. You so much, eh? Acha niongee na yeye nisikie anasemaje, Jose. Kufiti?
Yeah, mimi kufiti.
Kabisa?
Yeah, yeah.
Unasikia mzuri?
At least sasa nasikia niko na kanguvu kiasi. Yeah, yeah.
Sijali, kila kitu itakuwa fit.
Yeah.
Sasa?
Yeah, nashukuru Mungu. Yeah.
What about watu wale wamekuona na kukusupport, tutawaambia nini?
Mimi nasema Mungu tu awazidishie.
Tumia that camera.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah, Mungu awazidishie miaka, awabariki. May he open many doors for them. Mm-hmm. Yeah, cause wamefanya kitu poa. Cause kama si yao singekuwa hapa. God, Mungu aliwatumia kuni rescue and I appreciate a lot. I do thank them. Yeah.
That is amazing. Sijali naona tu uko na bruises. But guys, tumebidi tumvalishe shati kwanza na anini's hood kwanza because of his condition. But thank you so much guys for everything. Tutakuja hapa hivi. Tutam discharge. Tutaenda vizuri. And all is going to be fine. Mimi sijui niseme nini. I'm just a happy man that we saved a life. Because of the restrictions, because of other patients, we are going to cut the video. Because pia nasikia natoka hapa, apelekwa penya alikuwa, arudi vile alikuwa normal, and all is well. So guys, thank you so much for your time. Thank you for the support. And please, come on, just subscribe. Subscribe, sai, as we are speaking. Subscribe, 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 subscribe. Subscribe, subscribe, because hapa ni nyumbani. We are here to save a life. We have saved a life. Pia sisi tumesikia vizuri. Gift me that gift of subscription. Talk to me direct. Asanteni sana guys. Jose, sorry, atakuwa fiti na kila kitu itakuwa fresh. Thank you so much, my people. Till next time, guys. I love you all. See ya.